How we doing, everybody? Chef Joe Lester, Long Island Cuisine. So tonight, what I'm doing is marinating these pork ribs, okay? So what I'm gonna do is do a rub, and I'm gonna marinate it overnight, and then tomorrow I'm gonna make a nice, beautiful barbecued rib in the oven, all right? So I have cumin here, I have a little bit of cayenne, a little chili powder, I have 3 packets of sazon, okay? I have a nice little bunch of fresh cilantro, which I'm gonna chop. I have California garlic. Soon I'll have Rockham's Farm garlic. 2 limes that I rolled, and I'm gonna make this insane marinade, all right? It's like a rub, but tomorrow when I finish it up, it's gonna be absolutely beautiful. All right, so I'll see you in a bit. Okay, so we're back. So in this little bowl, I have 3 sazon, you know, 3 packages, 1 heaping teaspoon of fresh garlic, a nice little bunch of fresh cilantro, the juice of 2 limes. I'm going to add a little bit of cumin, not too much because this stuff is very strong. Yeah, we just want a little bit. All right. You see what I'm doing here? A touch of cayenne. That's plenty. And a little chili powder. Yeah, that's good. All right, so over here, I have these beautiful St. Louis ribs. And we're making this incredible rub. And I'm going to marinate this overnight, okay? Hold on. Yeah, this is going to be awesome. All right, so that's that. Let me put a little black pepper. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the rub on, and what I'm going to do is marinate this overnight in Ziploc bags, okay? And then tomorrow we're going to make this beautiful barbecue. All right, here we go. Oh yeah, look at this. It's going to be delicious. So tomorrow we'll be back. And I'll show you what we're gonna make for tomorrow, which is gonna be quite incredible. All right, now I'm just mixing this up. I put a little, like a 1/2 ounce of olive oil in here. And with the sazon, that'd be perfect seasoning. All right, now I'm gonna put this nice rub over here. All right, rub it nicely, okay. Oh yeah, man. These are nice flavors already. And the lime juice is gonna be helping with the, making it tender. All right. All right. Here we go. Oh yeah. So I did both sides because once I put it in the Ziploc, we're still gonna get all those flavors, all right? So now I'm gonna cut these the pieces like this. Okay. Yeah, this is perfect. Oh yeah. Let's get through that bone there. Perfect. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is put these in the Ziploc. And we're just gonna let this marinate overnight. And tomorrow will be another day. All right, folks, I'll see you tomorrow. Thank you very much. How we doing, everybody? Chef Joe Lester, Long Island Cuisine. So last night I showed you how to marinate the pork ribs. So I have 4 pieces of aluminum foil here. I have my ribs marinating in a Ziploc bag here. I have a greased parchment paper sheet pan, which I'm gonna put the ribs on, but I'm gonna wrap these in tin foil first. So I have the oven preheated at 350, and I'll be back. I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, so here are these beautiful marinated ribs that I marinated overnight. Just the smell alone right now, it's driving me nuts.
and I didn't even put them in the oven yet. So I'm gonna wrap these. I'm gonna cook these. I'm gonna check them in about an hour. And I have my Sweet Baby Ray's barbecue sauce, which I love. And I'll check this out in about an hour, and I'll see you soon. So you could see here that what I did is I took the ribs and I made like a little pockets, but I gently wrapped these loosely because after I checked this, when I add the Sweet Baby Ray's barbecue sauce to it, I'm gonna, it's easy to open, okay? Plus it's easy to clean the pan, the sheet pan. Okay, we'll be back. All right, so we have a nice barbecue ribs. So I cooked it for an hour and a half at 350. So I just added Sweet Baby Ray's. I'm gonna brush it on both sides. I have four of these bad boys. So I'm gonna put that back in the oven for about a half hour at 400 so it caramelizes. All right, we'll show you the final product. Okay, I'm going off the beaten path right now, but I'm gonna start a homemade macaroni salad. So I have the pot with maybe a half teaspoon of salt. And I'm gonna cook my pasta. And what I'm doing is fire roasting the red pepper. It's a fresh red pepper. And you just char the whole thing. Then what I do is I put it into a Ziploc and let it steam for about 20 minutes to a half hour. And then I just wash off the char. And this is going to be one of the ingredients I'm going to make the macaroni salad with. Okay, but that's going to go great with the ribs. I'm going to make a homemade coleslaw also. All right, see ya. Okay, so here we are. We're charring the red pepper. And I'm about to, this probably took about 7 minutes. And I'm going to put this into the Ziploc and let it steam. And then I'm going to take out all the char, in the cold water. And I'm going to use this part of this for the macaroni salad. But I'll show you that in a little while. Okay. Okay, back to the macaroni salad. I got the ribs out of the oven. That was in for an hour and a half at 350. And I'm going to add the Sweet Baby Ray's barbecue sauce in a little while. Put that back in the oven for approximately 45 minutes. Over here, I cook my pasta, okay. Over here I have an eighth of a red onion diced, three small stalks celery diced, two-thirds of a fire-roasted red pepper, one whole small tomato diced, and I'm just going to add these ingredients. I'm going to add a touch of red wine vinegar, salt, pepper, Hellman's mayo, and then I'll adjust the seasoning. Okay, I'll see you shortly. Okay, so now we're on to the homemade coleslaw. So I have my cabbage, my red cabbage, shredded carrot, a little bit of red onion. I'm gonna season it with salt, sea salt, black pepper, 1 teaspoon of sugar, about 1 ounce of milk, 1 tablespoon of fresh horseradish, a touch of red wine vinegar, and some Hellman's mayonnaise. So the horseradish is like the little secret here. So I'll show you the final product. Okay, bye-bye.
Okay, everybody, this is the end. I have my beautiful nephew, Gregory, and my beautiful new niece, Alexa. Okay, so what I did is I started a shrimp bisque yesterday, and that's what Gregory and Alexa wanted me to make. And I made these beautiful barbecue ribs, which I'm gonna put on a plate in a couple of minutes. I made homemade macaroni salad and homemade coleslaw. I mean, today, right now, you wouldn't think it's spring because it feels like winter. But anyway, I'm just chomping at the bit. I love my niece and my nephew, all of my nieces and nephews, and I'm just so lucky to have them here. And we're gonna feed them a little bit. But let me bring out these barbecued ribs, one sec. Okay, so this is the grand finale. So I have my beautiful nephew and niece, and so this homemade macaroni salad. Very simple, this is old world cooking, but delicious. Homemade coleslaw, delicious. Cornbread, and these ribs, what I did is I marinated them overnight.
I made this like beautiful rub, but I did add a little bit of olive oil and also fresh lime juice. So I cooked it the first time in the tin foil for an hour and a half at 350. Then I cooked this for another 40 minutes at 400, you know, to caramelize. So this is what we're gonna have tonight. And I'm so blessed to have my nephew and niece here. I wish all of my nieces and nephews were here, but I don't wanna have, you know, 50 people here. Anyway, thank you for watching Long Island Cuisine, Chef Joe Lester, and likes, comments, and what's the other one? Yeah,
shares.
Subscribe.
Shares.
You gotta share, yeah. Sharing is caring.
Absolutely.
All right, everybody. Enjoy.